You are in your late 60s.
Yes.
You still have a very active career in many ways.
Yes.
But you made a decision to go back to school at this point.
Like, well, you know what happened
is
that
so
now.
To me.
So my mom was Ingrid Bergman,
right.
A famous Hollywood actress.
I've heard of her. Yes.
Thank you.
We'll get to her in a second. Yeah.
So my mom always told me, but I didn't believe her.
Yeah.
So stupid. She said, you know, there is always a lull in a career of an actress. So you have a lot of role until you're 40, 45.
Right.
And then between 45 and 65, nothing happens.
Nothing happens, right.
Because you can't really play the love interest because you're too old. And you can't play the grandmother because you're too young.
Too young.
And they don't know how to place you.
Right.
And so this happened to me. And then at 65, it says works comes back. But my mom, unfortunately, died when she was 67.
Right.
So she was very relatively young. And the same thing happened to me.
In that down period
of 20 years, I had a lot of time in my hand.
Yeah.
And instead of being like an actress waiting by the phone, as we say about actresses, you know, waiting to get the role to go back, I just said, what else is interesting to me? And it was animals. Animal behavior. So I went back to university.
Yeah.
And then I created a kind of a parallel career that was still acting in the theater like I'm doing now.
But with this one subject.
And yes, and then as soon as I was working and I organized my life as a scientist, as a performer, a lot of work came back. Mama was right. After 67,
now suddenly,
65, and now I'm 67.
You're in
I'm
demand
doing a
again,
film,
right?
I'm doing this, I'm doing a photo shoot with Vogue and Elle, and I represent old women and we're still beautiful, and I'm so busy.
It's kind of great, isn't it? I know, yeah. Well. Good. You were patient and it all came back. That's how it all goes.
Yeah, I wasn't patient. It just happened. And I just thought, oh, my God, my mom was right.
I was right.
It must have been something that happened then, not now.
I was inclined to ask you how you became this person so interested in animals. But I know that your dad gave you a book when you were 14 years old, King Solomon's Ring. Ring.
And he's
an Austrian scientist, wrote this book all about animal behavior. Yeah. That's your first
moment.
He's
considered the founder of animal behavior. There were scientists about
that. The name of
animal.
The scientist is?
Conrad Lorenz. And he won the Nobel Prize in 1973 for having found a science of ethology or animal behavior that studies behavior. We cannot study thoughts because it's too secretive. How do you create an experiment of thought? But you can study behavior and communication, which is a manifestation of thought. And he studied animal behavior, and he founded this science that for which he won the Nobel Prize. And my father gave me this book, and it remained throughout my life my hobby, my interest.
Until now.
Until now.
Until now.